Good news for Pakistan. Professor Zulfikar Bhutta of Aga Khan University has made it to world's top 100 medicine scientists. Thank you, Professor, for making us proud. For those who think Pakistan's default is a myth, here is an eye-opener or an eyebrow raiser. Foreign investors have pulled US $12 million out of Pakistan in wake of high default risk. Welcome to Economic Outlook for the week ended May 22, 2022, presented by Paki News Network. Pakistan's debt has reached a new height of Pakistan rupees 53.5 trillion. However, current account deficit has narrowed by 39% owing to rise in remittances and falling imports. Pakistan Steel Mills Limited, which has eaten a lot of your taxpayer money, is likely to be privatized. All thanks to Shehbaz Sharif's government's proactive approach. Gross domestic product for coming year will be somewhere around 4.5%. Even this prediction is higher. Good times are unlikely to come for Pakistanis. Oh, I forgot to tell a bad news to those who have borrowed large amounts from banks that interest rate is once again likely to rise, which means interest paid by you guys will be going up. This interest rate hike is essential to control inflation. Government led by Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif has surprised many by raising 300 billion Pak rupees, as against 500 billion through auctioning treasury bills. Government cannot borrow from state bank and thus borrows from commercial banks. This time borrowing is at a lower interest rate. Central Development Working Party has approved four projects worth rupees 71.4 billion. These include construction of NIHD Research Center for Prevention of Cardiovascular Diseases, upgradation of National Institute of Medicine and Radiotherapy, and a World Bank-funded Agri Transformation Program. And in the end, a beautiful picture of Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif giving polio drops to a beautiful girl. Thanks for watching Paki News Network on YouTube.